The Apple Vision Pro releasing to the public is gonna end the repair industry, and we've got the data to back this up. See, the repair industry has thrived ever since phones were introduced, especially the iPhone. Shops started popping up left and right because customers are gonna go to a store where they see value, and the value which these repair shops provided was that they could fix devices cheaper than Apple, faster than Apple, and they soon started recovering data from phones which were denied by Apple. And so even though there were Apple stores opening up, people started to choose non-Apple repair. And this is gonna sound pretty dystopian, but customers actually having that choice to pick third-party repair left Apple with less money rolling in their pocket. So they fought back the best way that they could by making design changes that make their devices unrepairable. It's pretty crazy. And here's an example. When the new M1 MacBook Pros were being released, I was watching. I was on the couch, popcorn in hand, on the edge of my seat. Something so new, so special, so... Okay, I'll stop. Soon enough, people got their hands on these MacBooks and the screens broke. Because glass breaks. And as repair shops started getting them in for repair, changing the screens with OEM pull, meaning original screens pulled from other MacBooks, ended up with this distortion on the screens. The only way to get around this was to transplant a risky chip onto the new screen, and you risk burning the new screen because it takes a lot of hot air to solder the new chip off. This is just one example of how Apple's been serializing parts. There's a long list of examples. And eventually, this has to come to a breaking point where the devices become literally unfixable. And even the current landscape of VR, even without the Vision Pro, is already super annoying to repair. And here's what to expect. I've compiled a list of all of Apple's photos, videos, and clips of what the Vision Pro could be like. Here's what we know so far. From Apple's website and the factory video, under the hood, it looks completely jam-packed with technology. From this frame, we can see 9 connectors on the board. There goes the idea of a repair shop saving time. From the factory video, we see that the main curved glass piece is glued, yes, glued to the frame. The glue looks very similar to that on iPhone back glasses, and that glue ended up being so difficult that a laser machine had to be invented to make the job easier to remove the back glass. And if this is true, the glass is probably unremovable, unless you break it. It's probably not gonna be cheap. And in terms of cheapness, repair shops can only save customers money if they're saving money, and if the parts become completely serialized, which doesn't seem too far-fetched considering how sophisticated this technology is getting, there will be no cheaper option. And lastly, I have something which no one's talking about. Apple Care costs a whopping $500 for the Vision Pro. And listen, this number is worse than you think. If you want Apple Care for a $4,000 specced out 14-inch MacBook, which is more expensive than the Vision Pro, that's $279 for 3 years. Now the $500 price tag for Vision Pro is only for 2 years. $93 per year or $250 per year. Insane. And what's even more insane is the resellers on eBay who listed pre-orders for sale. Honestly, I can't even get mad at them. It's almost like the old days where scalpers would line up outside of the Apple stores, and the launch of a new iPhone was like Christmas for the world. And today it's become a way for people to make memes about stovetops. Who knows what the future is gonna hold? What we do know is that the future is being built as we speak. It's time that we build the future together. Thank you for your time.